Back it up. I really don't give a what you guys thought. Just back it up.
The king of the Klondike, Tony Beets, is in danger of losing his crown.
Things got to move. So once in a while, I have to sit in here myself. Move them trucks out of the way.
Nearly 2 months into the season, every miner in the Klondike is on the gold, except Tony, who hasn't mined a single ounce.
We're getting on in the season, and it's about time to get serious, I would say.
To hit his ambitious 6,000-ounce goal, 4 weeks ago, Tony moved his entire operation from Paradise Hill to Indian River. Now, he has some serious catching up to do.
Anyway, so we're getting this cut ready to sluice. Gotta have things ready to go.
So far, Tony's drained and stripped his flooded cut. Now, he wants to be running gold-rich pay by the end of the week.
We're gonna move the sluice box up here so that it's quiet in operation. By the end of the week, we can start sluicing. Put some rocks in the box, make a couple bucks.
Gotta get the shaker deck fixed up, you know, put together. Then the next big thing is getting in place. It just takes time because you have to get all these little things done. It's the little things, they get you. They always take the most time.
Tony's shaker wash plant has sat idle for 4 years and needs to be reassembled before he can start sluicing. To get back on track, Tony's crew must crane the 7-ton shaker deck up and swing it carefully into place on top of the wash plant's frame. Then, lift and swing the 2-ton spray bars above the shaker and bolt its 4 metal posts into position.
So all we gotta do right now is lift the up.
First, the enormous screen deck.
Okay, good, lift it up, cables above the screen deck. Okay, lift the thing up, see what's gonna happen with you, please. Gentlemen, at no point stand underneath the load, at no point. Okay, you hear that? Okay, that's good, Mike. Start swinging it. You pull it this way a bit. A little bit more, Mike, if you got it. How's the other side, gentlemen? Good?
Yeah, we're good.
Down? Well, that went easy. There you go. Nice to have toys. You wouldn't have toys, you'd be around with loaders, excavators. It really is the way to go.
Next, the spray bar assembly.
Okay, gentlemen, give Len a hand to hook it up. Okay, good. Okay, put a chain this end, put a chain the other end. Okay, Mike, lift her up there. At no point be underneath it.
No.
Okay? Where's he going? Whoa.
Should be very careful next time you walk underneath the load like that.
Mike, swing it my way.
Let go of the chain, walk around and load.
Oh my.
Hold it. Shut it up. You gotta be kidding me. You're not listening. Young fella, it's not funny. He cannot walk underneath a load. So this is the rule. You go home for the day. Get out of here.
I don't care if someone dies, because I just don't want to have to go to jail because they didn't pay attention when I told them to get out from underneath there.
Okay, over, Mike, swing it over. Hold it right there. Down ahead. Okay, kill the ain't good enough. So they went pretty good. I mean, screen deck went on like all.
And it's ready to go. All we have to do is drag it in place, put a pump in, and we're going. We're golden, literally.
So is there a little clevers on there so we can hook them on these things and drag this? Okay, lift it up, drag it out. There's a dozer on the way, we'll hook onto the sluice box, and then ho, off we go, I guess.
Tony Beets is finally on the brink of mining his first gold of the season. All that's left is to drag his shaker deck wash plant to the cut and start sluicing.
You know, in the end of the day, rule of thumb has always been that your money should come out of the ground, not out of your piggy bank. Let's get the together. Okay, let's go. Okay, better get over there and see if we can put it in the right spot right away.
It is nice that we got the water license. We've been waiting to sluice here for years. We have a lot of open ground and ready to sluice. Literally, the only thing stopping us right now is getting the plant set up.
Plant in place. Tony's one step closer to running his first pay dirt of the season.
I don't give a where the gold comes from, long as I'm getting it. And lots of it, I'll be happy. The wife be probably even happier, because the way I spend money, it's going out of style. Happy wife, happy life, so let's get some gold in the box, right?
Everything's here, all we have to do is start lining up.
Yes. What? Oh, look who's there. I see some inspectors on the way.
The Yukon's mining authorities are responsible for making sure all miners work within their licenses.
Well, you got some mining inspectors down there. They don't want to be filmed, so please shut that thing down, would you?
What happened?
We got them shut down.
After the surprise visit from the mining inspectors, Tony's race to get gold from his Indian River claims has come to a screeching halt.
Just had the inspector over, and guess what? I guess I better learn how to read, because we missed something in the license.
And what did we miss?
Apparently, for a class 3, I can only strip a very small area. So that means that's all we can sluice. So, pretty much, there's no use even being here. That's how little it is.
It's a catastrophic mistake. On his restricted water license, Tony can only strip and sluice 1 acre of ground, instead of the 15 acres he was planning to mine. If they can only sluice such a small area, Indian River will not be financially viable.
We hauled a lot of stuff here already. We put a lot of work and effort into it, so it would be nice to see that pay off.
It's pretty much my own fault.
We usually sluice about a month earlier than this.
Yep, that is a big thing. But, I mean, hey, like we had cats ready to go, a big time on this one.
If Tony can't agree a solution with the authorities, his Indian River claims will be shut down for the season. And his only chance of mining 6,000 ounces will rest solely on his paused operation at Paradise Hill.
All I can do is shake my head.
Okay.